71 in Medic 6. You're seeing a 74-year-old male, shortness of breath, down to two word sentences. History of emphysema is on hold. Hold 2. No release.
Today, if you were to have a friend or family member seriously injured in an accident, you would most likely dial 911. There, an operator will dispatch emergency services to your location, and within moments, highly skilled professionals will be at your side using the latest in medical technology to save your loved one's life. But what if none of these services existed? Back in 1962, they didn't.
There was a gung-ho group of firefighters who were assigned to rescue. And they said, we want to help people, and we're tired of holding them in our arms while they die.
Fire department was there. They had stations. They had equipment. They had personnel. If we had to buy all that, we couldn't have afforded hardly any of it.
There was no real model that we were following. Some of the stuff we were doing for the first time.
It was purely seat of the pants type training.
But you can take firefighters, the guys that play checkers in the fire station and you know, do these things and do this technical medical thing out in the field.
It was new, it was cutting edge.
We just found these dedicated firefighters who were willing to learn, willing to do things to help people become survivors.
No gloves. No rubber gloves back then.
Gloves were never thought of. You know, badge of courage if you got bloody on the scene and had to switch your new uniform two or three times a day.
Come back from a call and have to go take a shower to get the blood off of you.
Up until the time we came along, firefighters couldn't stick needles in people.
Doing an IV in the field, when we first started doing that, I mean, we'd have doctors and nurses walk up to us and say, what are you doing? You're not allowed to do that.
We were doing things that we really didn't have permission to do legally.
Back in the early to mid 80s, the cocaine use here in South Florida was probably at its peak.
Two adults were gunned down by the man who walked in and started firing.
It would be nothing. They have two or three gunshot wounds in a shift.
It was like the Wild West.
Dr. Nagel laid down on the city manager's desk and let one of the paramedics intubate him. And the city manager was convinced that this paramedic firefighter could actually do that to people in the field.
We were the first fire department air rescue system with a twin engine aircraft with the capability of having two paramedics in the back. I mean, that was unheard of.
We knew they were heroes before 9/11 took place. We knew that they were gung-ho, patriotic Americans who were willing to risk their lives and their reputations to do things to save lives.